I was a teenager, I took a trip to Buffalo River in Arkansas, and it was absolutely beautiful. And on that trip, we took a hike to a place called the Eye of the Needle. And as an inexperienced climber, it was kind of difficult. And I remember that specific moment that I lost my footing, I lost my rope, and I started to fall off that cliff. A lot of things run through your brain in that moment. And I did everything I could to just grab at whatever was around me. And finally, my hand found a bush. I grabbed that bush and it saved my life that day. I finished that climb eventually, and I was rewarded at the end by this beautiful scenery, this beautiful waterfall. And I went back several times over the years, and every year that I went, I finished that climb, and I was rewarded by what was at the end. Psalm 24, 3-4 says this, "Who shall ascend the hill of the Lord, and who shall stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not lift his soul to what is false and does not swear deceitfully." In this context and in others, the hill of the Lord represents higher spiritual ground, higher ground that brings us closer to God. When the Israelites would worship God, they would go up the mountain to the temple. When I climbed that trail for the first time, it was difficult, but I kept doing it. And eventually, it became easier as I became stronger and more equipped to handle that one climb. And for us, following God is like this. The more we seek Him, the easier it is to stand in His presence. The more we seek Him, the more we cleanse our hands and our hearts from sin. The more we seek Him, the less we give ourselves to what is false and deceitful. So, who shall ascend the hill of the Lord? Who shall stand in His holy presence? My prayer is that each of us today start climbing, be in God's presence today.
Bend our knees, O Spirit, come make us humble. We turn our eyes from evil things. O Lord, we cast down our idols. So give us clean hands and give us pure hearts. Let us not lift our souls to another, and give us clean hands, and give us pure hearts. Let us not lift our souls to another. Oh God, let this be a generation that seeks, who seeks your face.
Generation that sees.
We just stretch our hands to God and ask Him to give us clean hands, give us pure hearts, and let us not lift our souls to another. Give us clean hands, oh God, and give us pure hearts, and let us not lift our souls to another. Oh God, let us be a generation that seeks, who seeks Your face, oh God of Jacob. Oh God,